Good morning. We're going to talk about what you need to bring to see your probate attorney the first meeting. Obviously, you're going to need all of the information concerning the deceased person, name, address, hopefully date of birth and social security number, and date of death. Occasionally, some of that information won't be known, but gather up as much as you can. We'll need it all eventually. Next, we're going to need to know who his or her heirs at law were. Did they have a spouse? Is there anyone who might claim to be a spouse in order to inherit? Did he or she have any surviving children? How about deceased children who left children of their own? All of these people are heirs at law, but they may not be all of the heirs at law. Sometimes parents are heirs at law. Sometimes siblings are heirs at law. Sometimes even aunts and uncles and cousins. But generally, if there is a spouse and surviving children, the heirs at law will be those people. We will need their names and their addresses because they will be entitled to notice of what is happening in the probate case. They will also have the right to come in and object. We next need to know what the decedent owned. Did she have a bank account? Did he own a house? Was there a car? Occasionally, we'll need to know if there's life insurance. Generally, life insurance goes to the beneficiaries outside probate, but not always. If there is a need for life insurance to go through probate, you will usually have received a letter from an insurance company advising you of that. We're also going to need to know the decedent's creditors. Did they have a Visa card, MasterCard, American Express? Were they renting a house? Did they have any medical bills? If they passed away in a hospital, we for sure need to know the name and address of the hospital. Oklahoma law presumes that the hospital is a potential creditor. If the decedent went into the hospital by way of the ambulance, you should probably list the ambulance, maybe emergency room physicians as well. The law is a little bit less clear on those. We'll need to know quite a bit about you. Are you going to be the one who will serve as executor? If so, do you have any felony convictions? In Oklahoma, felons are not allowed to serve as executors. Next, have you filed bankruptcy in the last few years? Do you owe the decedent any money? All of these are issues that we should disclose to the court. They're not all automatic bans on you serving as executor, but we have an obligation to be candid with the probate court as to the conditions, because the probate court will be determining the amount of bond that you will have to put up, if any. Sometimes bond is not required. If there's real estate in the estate, we'll need to know whether you plan to sell the real estate during the probate. Sometimes we have no choice in that matter. There's just not enough cash to go around, and the real estate has to be sold to pay the bills. But often it's a matter of choice. Would it be better to sell the real estate sooner because there are mortgages on the land and payments that have to be made? Perhaps it's time to sell the real estate because this is the time of year that people are thinking about moving, and this is a house that would be very attractive in this market. At other times, you may not want to sell a property at all and desire to inherit it. This can be problematic if there's not enough cash in the estate to pay the bills, but we can sometimes work around that sort of problem. Just let us know what you want to do and why, and we'll try to help you find a way to get there. One of the issues that is likely to come up in the first meeting is how the court costs are going to be paid. Generally, we expect that our clients will bring to the first appointment enough money to pay the initial court cost, the publication fees, the cost of mailings and copying and the like. And generally, that's $500, maybe up to $600. It varies from case to case, in part determined by how many heirs are involved, and in part determined by whether you're going to sell real estate during the probate. If you have questions about what to bring to the office, just give us a call at 405-733-8686. In addition to myself, we have a couple of probate experts who will be able to help you with those sort of questions. And if they don't know the answer, they'll find the answer and get back to you.